الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The most popular surah of the Quran is Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
صدق الله العظيم. سميت بفاتحة الكتاب, the opening of the book. سميت بأم القرآن, the mother of the Quran. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة الحجر, ولقد آتيناك سبعا من المثاني والقرآن العظيم. Oh Muhammad, we have given you seven of the often repeated verses of the Quran. And many scholars believe that these verses are actually referring to the verses of سورة الفاتحة. Not only are we obligated to recite it properly in each prayer, we are also obligated to recite it properly in each rak'ah of each prayer. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, anyone who observes the prayer and does not recite Ummul Qur'an, the prayer is then insufficient and incomplete. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu is then asked, we are sometimes standing behind the Imam in some prayers and the Imam is reciting Surah Al-Fatiha out loud, as in Salatul Fajr and Al-Maghrib wal-Isha. Then Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, then you should recite it inwardly. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu then continued to say that he heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I have divided the prayer between me and my servant in two halves, and my servant will receive what he asks. When the servant says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, praise be to Allah, the Lord of the universe, the Most High, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, my servant has praised me. When the servant says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the Most Compassionate, the Most Merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replies, my servant has lauded me. And when the servant says, Malik Yawmuddin, the Master of the Day of Judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, my servant has glorified me. And sometimes he would say, my servant has trusted me with his affairs. When the servant says, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, we worship you and we rely on you for all of our affairs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is between me and my servant will receive what he asks. When the servant says, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, guide us to the straight path, the path of those upon whom you have bestowed favor, not of those who have invoked your anger or those who are astray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then replies, my servant has asked me and he should receive what he asked for. Surah Al-Fatiha is the definition of submission. Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Relying only on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And submitting all our affairs to Him alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we belong. And to Him we shall return. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala handles all affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that guides. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that controls everything and anything that we know of. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves our submission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the glorified, the most compassionate, the most merciful. So from now on, inshallah, when we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, we should know that it is a conversation that we are having with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to understand the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us closer to Him during this beautiful month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us closer to Him and forgive our shortcomings. That is Surah Al-Fatiha, the opening of the book, the mother of the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to understand the meaning of the Quran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.